Hello guys, and welcome to C Programming Tutorials by Amul's Academy. Previously in this video series, we discussed about the basic structure of C programming language, as well as we wrote our first program, that is printing hello world message on the screen. But to write and understand the program in any programming language, first we need to learn the basic concepts of that programming language. If you are learning any language, for example English, what will you do? First you will learn the alphabets, right? After that, using that alphabets, we will try to form the words. After learning to form the words, we will try to form a meaningful sentence from that words. Then after that, we can write the paragraph, poem, story, whatever we want, right? First we will learn the alphabets, next words, next sentence, next paragraph. In same way, while learning C also, we need to follow this process. First, we need to understand the character set, that is which and all character can be used in our program. Next, using that character set, how to define variables, constant, keywords, and how to use these concepts in our program. Next, using that variable, constant, and keywords, we'll try to form the meaningful instructions. Then we can arrange this instruction and we can write a program. So to write the program, first we need to understand the basic concept of that programming language. Alright, so first we'll begin with the character set. We'll see which and all character we can use in our program. Alright, we use English language in our program, right? So we can use A to Z alphabet, uppercase as well as lowercase. Then we can use digits, that is 0 to 9, as well as we can use the special characters, that is hash or pound symbol, star or asterisk symbol, lower than, greater than, dot, like that. First we can use the alphabets, that is uppercase as well as lowercase letter. Then we can use the digits as well as we can use the special characters in our program. We already wrote our first program, that is Hello World program, right? So I'll show you the which and all characters we used in that program, right? Okay, this is the Hello World program which we wrote in the previous tutorial. And here we can see the alphabets in lowercase letters, right? As well as we can see a digit, that is 0. As well as we use font symbol, full stop. And here we can see the special characters. Okay, this is about the character set. Next, we'll see what is variable and constant. If an entity doesn't change, then it is called as constant. If an entity does change, then it is called as variable. If any entity, if it is vary, then it is called as variable. If it is remain constant, then it is called as constant. In C programming also, constant is a fixed value that doesn't change its value during the program execution. It remains constant. Okay, so for example, 10, 1.5, a character H, or a sequence of character like programming, or we can say string. Okay, these are the constant which doesn't change its value during the execution of program. So these are called as constants, and the name given to this constant value in our program is called as variable. Variables are also called as the name given to the memory location. Okay, here 10 is a constant value, right? And here x is the name given to this value. So this is called as variable. It is called variable because it changes its value. It is not a constant value. We already familiar with this variable concept, right? In the mathematics, we use this variable concept, right? Actually, we'll write the program to solve the problems, like to find out the sum of numbers or the square root of numbers, prime numbers, Armstrong numbers. Okay, we'll write the program to solve the problems. While solving the problems, we'll do many calculations. Okay, and the result which we'll get from this calculation will be stored in the memory. Like human memory, computer will store that result in the computer memory. And computer memory contains different cells. Okay, here we can see, right? So each cell is called as memory cell or memory location, and here the data which are be used in our program will be stored. And each memory cell has its own address. So for example, if I take a value 10, if I use this value in my program, then it will be stored in any memory cell which is free. So we'll assume that this value will be stored in this memory cell. Okay, and this memory cell also contains its own address. Now if I again want to use this data in my program, then I need to retrieve this data from the memory. So to make retrieving process easy, we'll give name to that memory location, that is called as variable. If I give x is equal to 10, then this is the name of this memory cell. Okay, so if I want to retrieve this data, then you can retrieve using this name. Okay, here this name is called as variable and this is the constant value. So this is true that variable is the name given to the memory location, as well as it is the name given to the some value, because this is the value and this is the name given to that value. It is also an entity which does change, because after this statement, if I write the next statement like this, x equal to x plus 1, here x value is 10, 10 plus 1 is 11. So now x value is 11, right? So here in the memory, this 10 is removed and here 11 is stored. Okay, so here we can see previously x value was 10, now it is 11. So x value can be changed. So it is called as variable. Okay, so this is about the variable, but still much more is there to learn about the variable and constant. So we'll discuss about this variable and constant in detail in the next tutorial. So till then, take care.